because you assume that this government, or this particular government, abuses human rights anyway, then you have betrayed yourself and betrayed your profession.
So always verify the facts.
You have to verify the facts regardless. I mean, even if the party that you believe that you belong to is doing the wrong thing, you cannot just turn a blind eye and convince yourself that for the bigger sort of good, you shouldn't cover it. And that's where the problem is. But to combine in your activities aspects of activism and practices of journalism, I don't think it's impossible. And I think it can be complementary.
How do you see the media in Egypt 1 year after the revolution? Has there been a revolution in Egyptian media?
It's, I don't know, it feels like creative chaos in a way. Something I wouldn't have never been able to say when I was in the BBC, but I can say freely now that it's very fragmented, and I think it is a learning experience. I don't expect it to be perfect now. I'm very happy with what we have today, as opposed to what we had a year ago, and as opposed to what we had 10 years ago. It definitely is getting better, in my view, regardless to the sort of exceptional weird examples that we see here and there, and regardless to the fact that some of what I see I don't sort of feel comfortable with. But at the end of the day, we are learning as a nation and we are learning as a profession, and I'm sure it will be always for the best.
Hossein Soukeri, Head of Audience, Yahoo Middle East, thank you for joining us on the program.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.
محمد حسني مبارك تخليه عن منصب رئيس الجمهورية
It's a great pleasure to welcome Ebel Okobi, Business and Rights Program, Yahoo. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me here.
Ebel, what do you consider to be the main challenges impeding the progress of women?
I mean, that's such a big question, but I would say these are some of the things. I think this conference is a bit about what women's role is in government and politics. If you think about laws, and if you think about who's at the table when we're writing laws, I think laws that disenfranchise women are often written with women not in the room. So I think women not being in the room when laws are being written is a huge barrier. I also think that economic issues are a barrier as well. If a woman doesn't have access to her own to education, if a woman doesn't have access to the way to support herself, I think then she is always dependent. And so I think those are two huge barriers.
We saw how women were a big part of the January 25th revolution and how they have since been underrepresented and marginalized. What are the critical next steps to ensure that women are part of the development process?
Well, I think the point earlier about being in the room when laws are written is huge. To the extent that a woman is not in the room, and it's not that one woman represents all women's voices, but to the extent that women are not in the room at all, you can see the issues that are particularly important to women often do not get addressed. So I would say that is something that to think about. And we're looking at Egypt, but when I think about it, I think about it globally. So it's not just an issue in Egypt. I think it's an issue everywhere in the world. So women need to make sure that we have access to rooms. To halls of power. I think education is a huge thing that supports that. And it's something that as we think about sort of the future of the world for women, education is going to be very key.
What is Yahoo doing to empower and give voice to women around the world?
So I would say the platform. So one of the things that I think the internet does is that it gives a platform and a voice, and it amplifies voices that don't have access to traditional forms of media. People talk about citizen journalism, people talk about bloggers in the blogosphere. I think those are all wonderful things. But what they mean to me when I think about women is that you have someone who, we heard from the panel today, you have people talking, women who are in Saudi Arabia who say, I did not have access, my voice was not heard. But now that I'm able to tweet, now that I'm able to blog, now that I'm able to have access to information that I didn't have before, I am empowered. So I think that's something that is one small contribution that I think that any media company, but I think particularly Yahoo, which is an internet, a digital media company, this is what we can offer, a platform, a voice, an opportunity to amplify voices that haven't been heard. The second thing is that we connect. It allows women to connect to each other. 20 years ago, you could have a woman in Brazil who is working on maternal health issues, and she would never know the ideas that a woman in Cairo had or that a woman in Kenya had. I think one of the amazing things that the internet does, and of course we have to talk about access and how many women have access, but one of the things the internet does is that it connects those women. It allows them to build on their ideas and also allows them to be inspired. I think we also cannot underestimate the power of stories. So for a woman to stand up and tell her story, this is what I did, this is what happened to me. Just that one story inspires hundreds if you're in a room, but the internet is an audience of millions. So I think that inspiration, the ability to tell those stories and inspire people is something that Yahoo can offer, as given that we have a platform.
In this region, only 5% of the population use the internet. Many women are getting left behind. What is being done to encourage them to use technology?
I think you make an excellent point in terms of access. One of the things that, if you look at studies, they've found that in this region and throughout Africa and a lot of developing markets, mobile is the tool that people are using to access the internet. And I think that that's something for companies like Yahoo and all companies in the ICT sector to look at. How can we create platforms and products that engage people on mobile? Because one thing that we do know is that in many emerging markets, I mean, if you look at the penetration of cell phones or penetrations of mobile phones. I mean, there are some countries where there are like two mobile phones per person. So if you look at that and if you think about how can you innovate in a way that connects everyone who has a mobile phone to the internet and to this information. I think that that's an incredible opportunity for innovation and also an incredible opportunity to support women and to support voices.
Finally, what are you taking away from the Cairo Change Your World conference?
I can't even begin to say every single thing that I'm taking, but I would say a couple of things. One, that connection is so important. I heard so many women stand up and say, this is my hero. This is someone that I have followed for the past 5 years. This is someone I followed their story. So I think stories and connection and being able to have a platform that supports and advances those stories is critical. And certainly when I think about my work at Yahoo, it's certainly inspiring for me to think, when I go back to the business, to think about how can we do more of this? How can we be better? I think the other thing is that there are many, many diversities across the country and across all of these countries and across the region and around the world. But there are some similarities, and being able to connect people so that people can work off of those similarities is also a tremendous opportunity for us as a company. And finally, this is not really necessarily related to the internet or to technology, but I got a chance to sit at the table with some women who I call like our foremothers. Everyone talks about forefathers, but women who have been doing this work for 20 years, women who have been doing this work for 30 years, 40 years, and I think there's such an incredible opportunity to connect that generation with the generation who's doing that work here today. And I don't think we've talked about it enough here, and that's something I'd love to explore, because there are so many women who are heroes from 20 years ago, who can teach us so much now and make our combining together will make our work that much more powerful.
Abel Okobi, Business and Rights Program Yahoo, thank you for joining us on the program.
Thank you so much for having me. Thanks so much for coming.